Those are actually glory. You you must manifest in that. Hallelujah. Then you must manifest the glory of the Son in daytime. You must be making it. Praise the Lord. In daytime, when others are making it, you must be making time. You must be making it. In other words, when others are working, you must be working. Amen? The blessing, the glory of you not being idle must be there. Hallelujah. Then it is said, even the night, the moon time, the glory of the night, it is also there. When others are sleeping, you must also be manifesting, even if you are sleeping. Hallelujah. There are people who have been blessed in a way, even in daytime, and even when they are sleeping, the glory is still shining. Hallelujah. That is the plan of God. You make it in daytime. And even at night when you are resting, before morning, you are better than yesterday night when you went to sleep. Hallelujah. May you receive that glory in the name of Jesus. I pray, may you receive that glory in the name of Jesus. That is where you find somebody, man is working for you. You are asleep, you are resting, but man is working for you. Praise the Lord. Before morning, you find yourself, you are in another level that you were not when you were sleeping. Praise the Lord. Receive it in Jesus' name. Let the glory of the stars, everything you touch must shine in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Everything you give forth must shine in the name of Jesus. Your children must make it in life in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Your children must not be the last day. We have a passing glory. Anywhere you go, you must be felt. Hallelujah. You enter in office, people say someone has ended here. You enter in your home, people say someone has ended here. Nothing can happen in your home without you. That is the presence of the passing glory. Hallelujah. Anywhere you are, you preach it. That is the glory of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then we have the abiding glory. The glory that does not leave you. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. Anywhere you are, the glory is shining upon you. There are people you move them from here to Kitale, they will say. There are people you move them from here to Kakamega, they will say. They move from here to here, they will say. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But there are some people, you move them from here, where we are, to Aruku. Hallelujah. A matter of mine, millimeters, it is a prayer for me. God help me, now I will survive here. Glory to Jesus. Abiding glory is that glory. Anywhere you enter, you make it. Hallelujah. Any business you enter in, you are making it in that business. Hallelujah. Today you are selling tomatoes, you make it. Tomorrow you are selling meat, you are making it. Praise the Lord. That is the abiding glory. Anything you touch, it has to prosper. Hallelujah. Then we sow some of the things that may be glory. Not to manifest your life. We saw number one was what? Those who are there on Sunday and those who follow the teachings we need. Number one was what? Amen? I said this is a teaching church. Yes, you must carry a book and you must revise. We say number one?
Lack of respect and disobedience
to the things of God. So anytime the glory of God you want to leave you, you will live a life of disobedience. Amen? Living such a life, the glory of God will vanish from you. Praise the Lord. Then number two, we saw what?
Sin.
We saw when you dive yourself into sin, when you put the house of God, that is your body, the temple of God, you divide it, God moves away from you. We saw the Bible says, because of our iniquities, because of our sins, the face of God has been turned away. God turns himself away from you when you enter into sin. Number three, we saw it was what?
Our
names and your identity. Hallelujah. Your name will speak much about what to be and the glory you will carry. Amen. There's a name you can carry and you cannot portray any glory to anyone. Amen? There's a name you can give your child and a child will live a life of struggle for the rest of the life of that child. There's a name you can live in a place with a certain name and that name shall make people of that place live as the place is. Hallelujah.
Kama wewe unaishi mahali ama hapa kwetu kuna mahali tunaitwa Katina. Haleluya. Bwana asifiwe. Wewe unaishi hapa Katina. Mimi Katina it means something behind. No, you even the place, even right now, where in the place you behind houses, behind rivers to reach the cabinet, it is somewhere down there. It is behind everything. It is behind Kawagwa. It is behind Kangeni. It is behind Waruko. The place that it is, there. Now, you are living in such a place, you can't even grow in that place. Uh-huh. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm speaking to people here. Glory to Jesus. So go see where you live. Come on, akala mahali na jina ya hapo mahali ya ikupendezi tafadhali ama. Na wame haraka because you will carry the glory of the blessed. Amen. Unakaaba mahali unaitwa Sodom. Amen. Semi Sodom ni mbaya, mimi nasema maybe umeomba umeitakaza na damu ya Yesu. Lakini wacha nikwambie hiyo jina iko na maana mingi. Amen. So please, please. Please, hallelujah, let me not enter there. The name of the place, the identity can take away your glory. Amen. And we saw how God, for him to use some certain people in the Bible, he had to change their names to fit what he wanted. Then number four, we saw what? When you operate in the cause of evil covenant, the glory of God will move from you. Amen. You are under curse. Somebody has broken a curse on you. You have come from a village where people are cursed. You have come from a family where people are cursed. Let me tell you, you will never operate in the glory of God. You will struggle to operate in that glory. And the last thing we saw, operating from an evil foundation or an altar. Anytime you were dedicated or you started from an altar that was tainted, an altar that was not of God, anytime you came from that place, what it does, this altar, that changes your star and your book. Amen? So you find yourself, you cannot manifest in anything you are doing. Hallelujah. Now allow me to move from there. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. So those who are not there, you will get. For us who are there, let me handle another point that can take away your glory. Idol worship. Idol worship. When we follow our own opinions and our will, when we depart from the Lord, and we start worshiping and believing in other things other than God, when we put believing in before God, you have put your job first than God, you have put your wife first than God, you have put your children first than God, you have put man first than your God. Let me tell you, what you have put first becomes an idol, becomes a God to you. When you find yourself, you operate in such area, God needs you, and you will not operate in the glory of God. Hallelujah. The job has become an idol to you. Hallelujah. When you disobey the things of God, the God takes away your glory. Amen. 1 Corinthians 10:19. 1 Corinthians. The glory of God can depart from you. Because God does not allow to be shared with anything. God is very jealous now. Uh-huh. Let's hear.
1 Corinthians 10:18.
Uh-huh.
What do I mean then?
What do I mean then?
That a thing offered to idols is anything special
or is anything special? Offered to idols special or anything? This was a question Paul was asking the Corinthians. Uh-huh.
Special or changed simply because it is offered?
Uh-huh.
Or that an idol is anything?
It's an idol of anything. Uh-huh.
On the contrary,
yes,
the things which the Gentiles sacrifice,
the things which also do not believe sacrifice.
They sacrifice to demons in effect.
The things that you put all your time in, you are bringing it to the demons.
And not to God.
And not to God. So if you love your family so much, your children so much, beyond God, let me tell you, you are sacrificing to the demons, not God.
And I do not want you to become partners with demons.
And God is saying, I do not want you to become partners.
By eating a feast in pagan temples.
By eating a feast in pagan temples. Hallelujah. The other parts of that say, can you share in the table of the enemy and the table of God? You cannot share in that table. What does it do? God is so jealous. God will not allow you to dine in the table of the enemy and again dine in the table of God. He will not allow. God is a jealous God. You cannot be offering sacrifices to the enemy at the same time. God is still saying he will cut you off. You will never operate in the glory of God. Hallelujah. Some of us have come to places where we used to worship idols. We used to worship things that did not please God. God's glory moved from us. Saul was a king who disobeyed God, and the glory of God moved from him. 1 Samuel 15:23. The man, God saw him, he was a great fighter. But let me tell you, when God withdrew his glory because of disobedience, the man lost his kingship.
For rebellion is as serious as a sin of
Rebellion is so serious, it's like the sin of rebellion.
And disobedience is as serious as false religion and idolatry.
Oh, yeah. And disobedience, arrogance, is like the evil of idolatry. What does it mean? When you are ignorant, let me tell you, of the things of God, when you are not following the things God has put before the commands of God, when you find yourself you do not follow it, it is like a sea of idolatry. So you are worshipping idols. When you become ignorant of the things of God, a children of God, we must never be ignorant of the things of God. Saul became an ignorant of the commands of God. And he disobeyed God. And the hand of God was taken away from him. The man ruled for 44 years. But he was with God for only 4 years. Hallelujah. The man was there as a king. But God really threw him. And God was seeking for somebody to replace him while he was still the king. Amen. Let me tell you, every time you disobey God, you disobey the commands of God, the statutes of God, God leaves you. The glory of God is taken away from you. You do not operate in the glory of God. You find yourself, you are struggling. You find yourself, your face is shaking everywhere you go. Why? Because you have entered into idolatry. I pray for you. From today, in the name of Jesus, you shall not enter into the idolatry in the name of Jesus. You shall understand the things of God. And every time you shall be found in the ways of God. Hallelujah. That is how you find people losing the glory of God. Unatoka hapo na hiyo unafanya dhambi. Na wewe unajua ni Mkristo. Wewe ni kiongozi wa kanisa. But you are involved in things that do not please God. Hallelujah. You become ignorant of the things of God. The glory of God is taken away from you. Amen. It will not be your portion in Jesus' name. Then the last one, operating in wickedness. What can take away the glory of God is when you operate in wickedness. There are people who have been raised and who carry the spirit of destroying others. There are people who carry the spirit. They cannot stop at people. They cannot allow people to be. There are people, every time you are progressing, they think there is something eating them and it is not from them. Hallelujah. Even when you are eating your food, they are doing it. When you enjoy your marriage, they are not happy. How can she enjoy a marriage? When you are giving back, they are still talking. And
they do not come to help you make the maternity ward. They do not come to help you and pay fees for your children. But when they see you having more children, they are talking. Wicked people. These are the people who raise and they start cutting your legs. They start cutting your energy. They say no. Over my dead body, she cannot succeed. Over my dead body, she cannot buy a car. Over my dead body, she cannot marry. These are wicked people. When you find yourself, you are parading in wickedness, the glory of God goes. It is taken away from you. This one is in hole. I can repeat and I mean it when you can go. Hey, unaanza kumwambia hichi hichi. Let me tell you, you are a wicked person. And every time you find yourself operating in wickedness, God takes the glory from you. You start a life of struggle. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You get an answer who has come. You have been here for years. But somebody has come who is mighty to everybody, who is greeting everybody well, who is welcoming people to their seats well. Yes, you have been there for years. And everybody is saying, hallelujah. This was the one we have been waiting for. This was the lady who we are looking for now. That you have been there for years. You start crooning. You start now having long faces because the lady has come. And everybody has turned the face of that car. You start saying, hey, I'll pay me. Why does it feel? A wicked person, the glory of God will never be there. Hallelujah. It happened in the Bible. Amen. Esther 7:7. There's a story there of Esther and his uncle Mordecai and Haman. Haman wanted to finish the Jews due to a long and urgent problem that was there in their foundation. And Haman planned evil and was wicked. He did not want these people to inherit anything. He did not want them to matter anywhere. So the man planned evil against Mordecai. Planned evil against the family of the Jews. He wanted them to be killed for him to take lead. He wanted him to be on top. He wanted him to be everything and them not to be there. But let me tell you one thing. The wickedness the Lord has said, their days are founded in the name of Jesus. The Bible says, my God will raise against the wicked. My God will raise against the evil. The Lord raised against the wicked plans of the enemy.
Esther 7:7. Then in his fury, the king stood up from drinking.
Now the story has gone. And he entered to bless the kingdom to know the plan. And when the king knew the plan of what was supposed to be done by Haman, the king became so annoyed. And he woke up one day, who is this? He that he can act, my wife, praise the Lord. Let me tell you, you shall plan evil for others, but as you are planning evil for others, the God who we serve, who does not slumber, he will arise the time you are planning evil, and he will come and say, who is this? Who's planning evil to the anointed one of the Lord? Who is this who's planning evil to the ones I love so much? And God will arise and start fighting. The king arose and asked, who is this?
The king stood up from drinking wine.
Yeah.
And went into the palace garden.
Yes.
To decide what he should do. But Haman stayed to plead for his life.
Yes.
From Queen Esther. For he saw that Haman had been determined against him by the king.
The man realized things have started working against him. And he was pleading, saying me. Let me tell you, if the king did not know, the Jews would have been destroyed. Because a declaration had been passed to finish them. But they did not know. When you are operating on wickedness, let me tell you, the hand of God is removed. The glory that man was enjoying, it was withdrawn. And the word he had planned to happen to Mordecai, it happened to him. Let me tell you, wicked people, the arrows you shoot, they always are fast back to you.
Amen.
These are the people who plan for you to be sacked when you are supposed to get a promotion. Let me tell you, even them, they seek the sacrifice. These are the people who will never want your children to go to the good schools. These are the people who come to change the stars of your children. These are the witches and the wizards who raise against you. I pray for you in the name of Jesus. Every wicked person among us yourself. Hallelujah. We shall cut your legs. Let me tell you. We shall drop in the spiritual rain. And we shall get you. We shall discover you. And we shall fight you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. You cannot be that person who is wanting others to be useless. To be done. You do not want others to go home. Let me tell you. Every wicked person, the glory of God has been on you. Amen. The glory of heaven. The man was almost being a prime minister of the land. It was taken from him. And Mordecai started enjoying what was meant for Aman. One has a figure. Let me tell you, any wickedness is punishable by God. You cannot be wicked and God blesses you. It cannot happen. Hallelujah. Wickedness, it is cut by God. The glory will disappear when you are wicked. Amen. You must not be wicked. In Jesus' name. Amen. Then allow me to end up briefly about the dimension of glory. Hallelujah. You are seeing what can take away the glory of God. Now, there are dimensions. There are stages. You can operate in the glory of God. Amen. Yes, you have the glory, but I come to speak to somebody. Just not the glory you must operate in. I need you to operate in another dimension of glory. Hallelujah. Yes, you have the heavenly glory. Yes, you operate in the heavenly glory. But I need you to operate in a new dimension. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Anyone who must enter in another realm of dimensions of glory must be a person also operating in higher realms. Hallelujah. Of glory. For you to prosper, you must operate in dimension, in higher senses of glory. Number one thing, a dimension of glory that can make you succeed. Number one is the glory of God's presence. Anywhere you are, you are operating in the glory of the presence of God. That is the highest dimension of glory you can operate. Let me tell you, anyone who is operating the glory of God, you cannot be the last. Anyone who is operating the presence of God, God leads you. He commands your steps. Anywhere you go, God is the one who is leading you. You cannot be found in the wrong place. Why? Because you are operating in the presence of God. Because anytime you are in the presence of God, God is speaking of you. God is leading you. God is commanding angels to take care of you. You cannot be mad. You cannot lose anything. Operating in the presence of God, you are on top and on top of them. Hallelujah. Operating in the presence of God, that is the highest. John 1:2. What does he say? This is the point you operate in everything. Hey?
1 John 1:2.
Beloved. Beloved.
I pray that in every way you may succeed.
I pray for you, this is the point. That in every way you shall do what? In every way, not in one way. Glory to Jesus. Operating the presence of God is not one way. It is saying in all ways, I pray for you. I grant to you the glory. Yeah?
That you may succeed.
That you may succeed.
And prosper.
And be
in good health. Physically. Just as I know you're so
blessed. The Lord is saying, beloved, I pray that you may prosper. In all things you may prosper. In everything you do, you may prosper. In everything you may be in top, you may increase. That is the presence of
Hallelujah. God is saying, He's granted us that in all things, in your health, in your finances, in everything you do, in your house, in your working place, the glory is shining. The glory is shining. The glory is shining. Why? Because God has given it to us. It is a command. It has come to pass. In all things, those who operate in the presence, the highest glory of God, the presence of God. Hallelujah. Amen. Not one thing. Hallelujah. Si ati unavaa mzuri leo na sasa hivi umevaa mzuri hata kwa mfupa una chochote. Unaona mtu anashukishwa gari. Jamaa amevaa mzuri hata tikisa mzuri. Na akifikiwa na kondakta na leo mzee sina yote kondakta anamuuliza na vile umevaa. Unajua kuna aibu zingine, let me tell you. God must remove in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We shall portray the glory we have in the name of Jesus. In all things, we shall have everything. You travel in that 3:14. Must prosper in health. Must prosper in your soul. Must prosper spiritually. We must prosper. In all things.
Amen.
Spiritually, you must be alive. Why? The glory has been released for you to be alive. Amen.
Deuteronomy 33:14. With the precious fruits of the sun and with the precious produce of the month.
Yes.
With the best things of ancient mountains.
Yes.
And the precious things of the
world. Now repeat again. I want to see. I'm going to get this in our Peter. Repeat for the Paul. Hallelujah.
Deuteronomy 33:14.
Yes.
With the precious fruits of the sun.
With the precious fruit of the sun. It didn't have anything good. You shall prosper in it. It is meant for you. Praise the Lord. Yes.
And with the precious produce of the month.
Yes. In the precious produce of the month. Oh, everything you must receive in the month. Everything you must receive every day of your life. Oh, you must prosper. It must be a benefit to you. It must be good. You must say it is good. Hallelujah. Every time you are waiting must be good. It is the mission of growth.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Hey, whatever you are receiving, oh, you get everything you need and you are left in surplus. Oh, how can I speak to somebody? Hallelujah. 1 Kings 8. Pastor King, there was a man. Then the Bible was operating in a new dimension of glory. The man encountered God. Because anytime you operate in the glory of God, there is always the presence of God. Everywhere you go, you are operating dimensions of glory. The man, Solomon was operating another dimension. Oh, glory to Jesus. Everywhere he was, dimensions was happening. Hey, just
1 Kings 8:30. I've certainly built you a lofty house.
Now I need you to read verse 11. You go read from verse 1 to 13, but I need you to read verse 11.
So the priests could not stand in their positions.
Now the man carried glory. The man was a servant of God. The man had believed in God. The man had given God everything. This day the man is gone from the altar of God. He had brought it to the house and built it. And the man had sacrificed to God. He had given millions and thousands of cows on the altar. And he had carried the presence of God. The heart of the covenant was there. So the man had invited the presence of God. Now what was happening that day? Now wait.
So the priest could not stand in their positions.
The priests, the pastors, the bishops could not withhold. They could not withstand. What?
To minister because of the cloud.
To minister because of the cloud.
For the glory and the brilliance.
Now the cloud was the presence of God. For the glory of God was where? Hallelujah. For the glory of God was where? We are preaching together with you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Continue. Glory to Jesus. It must reach a point that you serve God in His presence. That anywhere you go, all of the cloud of the glory of God is ever there. I pray for you, you shall end up blessed.
Oh, the glory of dressing. Let's take that easy. Oh, thank you, Jesus. I told you glory must be seen. Hey, hallelujah. Glory to Jesus.
Glory! And the Bible says the man King Solomon. Solomon dressed well and God liked it. Hallelujah. Solomon was a man who was wearing the glory of God. And even touched God in the silver. And the man, God liked it. Matthew 6:39. Let's hear what this man was doing. Hallelujah. Matthew 6. I told you this is a lightning church. Oh, apart from the Tambuaga Bibilia, let me tell you, we get the real word from the word of God. What does it say?
Matthew 6:29.
Yes.
Yet I say to you,
yes, I tell to you,
that not even Solomon in all his glory,
not even Solomon in all his glory, even God realized the glory the man was carrying.
And Slaver dressed himself like one of these.
Yeah, my Bible says, yet I tell you, even Solomon, you know, is magnificent, excellent, dignity, and grace of blessing. Hallelujah. Oh, there was no man like that man. Hallelujah. Let me tell you, I pray for you. You shall carry a glory that your maker will one day awake and say, nobody in this world carries the glory like my son. I pray for you. In the name of Jesus, you shall carry a glory. Even God will testify for you. You shall enter a place and God will say, this way.
Amen.
Hey, first key. 10:4-7. First key. First key 4. Talita. This man carried a glory. Hey, dress can speak for you.
Amen.
Dress can make a change.
Yes.
Oh, I tell you. 4. I say, First Kings. First Kings 10:4. Hey, Annette. Raboshi can never see. Hey, Holy Ghost fire is on you. In the name of Jesus. Oh, dress speaks for you. Amen. Okay, First Kings 10:4. To say that, hallelujah, holy. Yes.
When the queen of Sheba had seen all Solomon's wisdom and skill,
this man was so famous with the glory of God. Until he touched a certain queen who was in a certain land, she heard the rumor about Solomon. Amen. I pray for you. Your glory will touch them.
Amen.
Oh, they will never sleep. They will be awakened today and say, let me go and see the glory of Abraham. I have heard of this man. I have heard people talk about it. They will listen. Somebody will be awakened. Somebody will awaken somewhere. And we will be saved to come and see the glory you are manifesting.
Amen.
Thank you. They were all of God. The Roman came and looked and said, oh yeah, oh, this is the glory of God. The Roman started being a prophet and started telling someone, yes, I have a heart, but today I come to see with my own eyes. I have seen what God has done for you. Oh, I have come and seen. And the woman did not come empty-handed. When she saw what the blessings have been released to someone, oh, she will come carrying her. Yes.
Behold. The half was not all of me.
Yes.
You have added wisdom and goodness.
I want to be a dear daughter. In fact, what I've seen with my eyes,
hey,
the eternalness is not what they told me.
Hey.
What now I've seen is more than what they told me. Continue.
You've added wisdom and goodness exceeding the fame I had.
You have added goodness.
Hey.
Ooh. They will come and see you and say, man, what I am is not what I'm seeing. Yes, they say, but they left some things. Now what I'm seeing something beyond what they told me. That is the God. The man was dressed well. I pray for you. Let me tell you, dresses will introduce you. Let me tell you, every time you dress well, every time you do things well, you feel good. They will try to open their mouth, they will be fine. The Bible says, the another version that says,
she fainted.
She fainted in that version. The survivor that says, the woman saw the queen. She saw what someone had. The woman fainted. She collapsed. Because of what she saw, they will collapse in the name of Jesus. The blessing you shall carry, the glory you shall proclaim from today. Your daughters
they'll faint.
Appearing
Jesus
in those family meetings. Oh, now you may not. They would have gone to a father. Hey! Now you may not. They want to appear. The way they enter the commanding style. Oh, you have never seen it, but your children have seen it. Because let me tell you, the glory will go to generations. It may not be you, but your children will enter the generation. The glory of blessing will rock it. Wherever you are, the man was dressed. Then the last glory, you must operate in another dimension, is financial glory. Kalipa, let me tell you, you do not carry, you do not operate in dimension financial glory. You'll be the loving stock of everyone. You people will be laughing at you. People will be talking about you. People will be saying, this world does not happen. But let me tell you, any time you start operating in a different financial glory, dimensions, finances, oh, then you talk about you, First Kings, the 7:10-7. Hey, read it there.
I did not believe the report until I came and saw it in my own.
If property exceeded his faith, I pray for you that whatever you shall have shall exceed your faith in the name of Jesus. I pray for you that whatever you shall possess from today, it shall exceed the world that shall take it. Hallelujah. That is the power of God. Ah, read verse 21.
All King Solomon's drinking vessels were of gold.
Now listen.
Everything you have,
the cups, the spoons. Oh, the washing vessels. Ooh. When I see the buckets, they were all of God. The fame of the man, everything was God. In other words, everything the man had was of real money. I pray for you that everything you suffer shall not be real money. Your shoe, your back, your hand, and everything you have, your ears, your chain shall be your money. Your lips, the carpet shall look at it. The glory of our finances is where it is. Oh, I thank God. Oh, hallelujah. We go to the salons, we go to. No matter to Nashuka, Mabila to Nashuka, because it is in a bandilica. She was around the Sasaka, Homo, Mabila to Lucia to Nainana, Nipasala, the glory of our finances in the Fikia. Oh, the food we eat, no matter the dessert, I see the shape. They are called what? Kills. Some of I shall eat those weapons. They are sick for me. I shall pay and my body hurts. There are some foods you don't eat. Let's go now. Oh, you will not take the tea you take. Chei na chambusha pamoja na majani dani. Ina koroka yote. Hata wewe ndio unapewa kazi ya kukimbia. Wakoe wewe tena kuna watu wanakuna na chai ya wachungi. Yeye ametengeneza fangi ya wanakuna. Dimensions. Come and say dimensions. I shall pray that dimension for heaven. Hallelujah. My friend, they are those dimensions. Hallelujah. There's a shoe you wear. There are no speeds will pass. Say my shoe. This one cannot enter my body. This one even the elders can hear me. I'm inventing my life. Hallelujah. In other words, the shoe is speaking to you. It's telling you the place you are living. It is not fit for you. You are supposed to go to another dimension. You are supposed to live in another dimension. Now I don't want to get it. 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 Now I don position of an house. You. Even the rat. If you are asked where you are taking,
then when you where you put your hand, you are where your hand is seated by your hands. My God, Lord Jesus, I pray today in the name of Jesus. Oh, I can panic in another dimension. I refuse to be poor. Dimensions of dimensions.
Amen. Dimension is this. I refuse in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. You shall keep your mind where and get it safe. No wonder you wake on a cargo, then look at a year. I'm a man who you don't know. No matter what I see, no way. I don't know the shoe for the water of the other water. Not in my pilot, then my corporations are not there. I refuse to live in such a house. Huko atafuta kula. Wanaongelesha na huko nje. Mapanya. Anasema huku. Hapana. Huku. Huku sio kweli. Wanapinduka wanaenda. Yesu is your portion in Jesus. So the man was blessed. The man had everything. The man carried everything. He surpassed everything. And the Lord said, he surpassed all the kings of the earth by his riches. Verse 27.
The king made silver as common in Jerusalem as stones.
Yeah.
And cedars as plentiful as the sycamore trees that are in the lowlands.
And verse 23.
So King Solomon exceeded all kings of the earth in wealth and in wisdom.
The Bible says King Solomon exceeded all the kings, even including our world here. Yeah. The man was rich. God in that verse, where that chapter, when this queen came and saw Solomon, she came and carried God to him. The day the woman started going home, Solomon says, stop, wait a minute. Solomon packaged that woman with the gold. Hey, marakumi ya vila alikuja. The woman carried more than what she came with. But he said, hey, no wonder she faded. And to be Solomon, he began to do later. Solomon collected that woman to be his wife. The woman became Solomon. She said, there is no man in the world. This is my husband. She came back. The queen did it and she was married. I pray for brothers who are here who are not married. May God bless you financially. into a financial glory. Don't miss a Sunday. Invite somebody. You must know how you will have more than enough. Come and use your hands. Father, we thank you. We bless you for your day. Thank you for your word that has come in power. We bless you because God is operating new dimensions of life in the name of Jesus. I pray today, Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, dimensions of your person, dimension of your presence, dimension of blessing, dimension of finances, oh God, and His glory, we shall enter in the name of Jesus. I pray for today, Lord God. They shall look at me and say, "Shall my God is alive." They shall say, "Let me serve the God of my brother, the God of my sister, because they shall be seen in the mighty name of Jesus." You shall operate in that glory. I prophesy in the name of Jesus. Operate in that new dimension. Operate in that new dimension. Operate in that new glory. In the mighty name of Jesus. It is your portion. In Jesus' name. Oh God, receive all the glory.